Welcome to the EE Research Seminar Series. In this seminar, we'll use academic research to explore how environmental education programs can influence participants' sense of place. Imagine you and your friends taking a walk in your neighborhood. You see the same buildings and landscapes and hear the same sounds, but your perceptions of this place may be different. If you've lived in this neighborhood for a long time and you identify yourself as an environmentalist, you may be very attached to this place and perhaps you'll recognize and appreciate its green features, such as trees and parks. And if your friends are artists, they may pay more attention to art in your neighborhood, such as graffiti and features of buildings. In other words, people have different sense of place depending on their background, personal history, and interests. Sense of place. The way you perceive places combines place attachment and place meaning. Place attachment is the strength of your connection to a place. If you really want to visit or stay in a place, probably your place attachment is strong. And place meaning describes what a place means to you. Place meaning can reflect cultural, political, historical, ecological, or other aspects of places. People can be attached to a place for different meanings. For a logger, a forest would mean timber and a source of income. An artist may view the same forest as a place of solitude and source of inspiration. The ecological dimension of place meaning is especially relevant to education programs that are trying to help people understand and value ecological features of their communities, such as street trees, community gardens, and green infrastructure. Researchers often measure place attachment and place meaning through surveys, one of which we'll discuss soon. You can also learn about people's place meaning through interviews, stories, journals, or by discussing with them photographs of places. You may also ask students to take photos of places or objects that are meaningful to them, and then discuss what those objects mean to them. But why should we care about sense of place? Research shows that sense of place is linked to pro-environmental behavior or behavioral intention, such as willingness to conserve local natural resources or help restore damaged streams or neglected parks or other pieces of land. In addition to pro-environmental behavior, research proposed that certain sense of place facilitates more positive experiences of places and contributes to human well-being. Finally, ecological place meaning might help people value and use environmental features of places, such as parks and rivers, and also imagine how places are changing over time and how they can be improved in the future. Researchers have described factors that may influence sense of place. If we know what factors influence sense of place, perhaps we can use this knowledge to improve the design of our environmental education programs. Sense of place, including place attachment and place meaning, can emerge through direct experiences of places. If you live in a specific place for a long time or frequently visit it, your attachment to this place may grow. Your place attachment may also strengthen if you invest your time and energy in place, for example, through environmental volunteering and stewardship. Frequent park users may become more attached not only to a specific park, but also to any parks, including those in other regions. Your place meaning can also develop through hands-on, direct experiences of places. The physical environment, such as landscapes and buildings, may facilitate the creation of particular place meanings. Your activities and interactions in places also contribute to what this place means to you. At the same time, some meanings of places are invisible. For example, community history and ecological knowledge can be only learned from other people through stories, lectures, movies, books, discussions, or interpretations. Finally, your self-identity, how you view yourself, may influence what meanings you ascribe to places. Do you think any of these factors can be used in environmental education programs? For example, since we know that direct experiences and stewardship contributes to ecological place meanings, we may include stewardship activities in our environmental education programs. Cornell University researchers conducted a study to investigate the impact of urban environmental education programs on sense of place in high school students in the Bronx in New York City. Students participated in 6-week environmental and non-environmental summer youth employment programs. Students in the experimental group participated in environmental monitoring, field trips in the city, environmental restoration, and activism. Students in the control group participated in art, photography, sport, and literacy projects. Surveys conducted before and after programs show that students' place attachment did not change in either environmental or the control group doing art and other activities. But ecological place meaning did improve among environmental students. This means that participation in urban environmental education programs in the Bronx helped students view the city as an ecologically valuable place where one can grow healthy food, observe birds, restore riverbanks, and enjoy community events in parks. The research suggests that ecological place meaning is probably influenced by hands-on experiences in places, by social interactions with environmental professionals and educators, and by students' emerging ecological identity that reflects empathy or care for nature. Many environmental or place-based education programs intend to improve sense of place among children and adults. Place-based urban youth development or other education programs realize that connection to and understanding of places may foster pro-environmental behavior, may help people benefit from local environmental treasures, and may unleash their imagination and creativity for transforming their neighborhoods into better communities. These education programs in schools and community-based organizations are often inspired by existing research in environmental education literature, as well by educators' practical experience. In Manhattan, high school students from the John Lindsay Wildcat Academy Charter School helped to plant, grow, harvest, and sell vegetables at the Battery Urban Farm in downtown Manhattan. Initially, probably for many students, Manhattan means tall buildings, subways, and busy streets. Research would suggest that by volunteering in an urban farm, students may begin to view the city as a place to grow food, as a place where the land meets the harbor, and as a place to make friends outdoors. In the South Bronx, students and other community residents learn about oyster reefs in the Bronx River through ecosystem restoration, monitoring, and recreation. Through after-school programs and community events, the organization called Rocking the Boat takes students and adults on boats to the Bronx River, from which they can see that the Bronx is a mix of industrial landscapes, residential areas, and natural areas. Research would suggest that through direct experiences of urban places and through interaction with environmentalists, students strengthen their ecological place meaning. They get to understand that they don't have to go somewhere else to be in the environment. Educators in these programs understand that the way you perceive your place may influence how you manage or interact with it. If your ecological place meaning is strong, if you think that your urban or rural place is ecologically valuable, then you might be more likely to protect or improve it. You may also be more likely to enjoy its natural features, go outdoors, pay attention to animals and plants, and participate in community events and parks. You can learn more about sense of place or its applications to environmental education through selected publications. In addition, you can adapt and use in your program a sense of place survey from this open source article. EE Research seminars are designed to help you understand environmental education research and to improve your environmental education programs. Thank you for watching this video and be sure to check other EE Research seminars.